Hey, it's Nightshroud99 again, doing a review on a new LEGO Marvel Superheroes Loki's Cosmic Cube Escape. 181 pieces, 3 brand new figures, little comic book, and it costs 20 US dollars. I got it at Walmart.com. It's out of stock and actually gone now. And also got the Wolverine's Chopper Showdown, which is X-Men. This is Avengers. And here's the box. Ugh. Looks very cool. Lego Superheroes Marvel has the Avengers in the front there. The X-Men one has Wolverine, because, yeah. It's good that they haven't made any more X-Men besides Wolverine. And Loki's Cosmic Cube Escape. Comic book included. And you get Loki, Hawkeye, and Iron Man. The back. That's one of the play features. And then, of course, is Flickfire Missiles, and that's Iron Man's helmet. Looks pretty cool. And here's another shot. The actual movie characters. Manual. There's one manual. No numbered bags. There's 2 bags. There isn't anything in the manual except I'd like to show you a new piece, which I'm pretty sure is new. And I would, I can't really show it to you on the truck itself because it's built into it. It's actually this right here. It's like a little snot, you know. So you can build it on the side. So I thought that was, I'm pretty sure that's new and looks pretty neat. Now before I get the figures, show a little comic book. This one is number 2. And here it is. Yep, all the Avenger figures available at the moment. There's going to be more. And there's also X-Men, the sets. There's also a picture of Spider-Man in here, but I haven't got there yet. So this is actually the comic book for Captain America. I'll show that, you know, when I get the set. But these are all the figures in the Marvel line so far, and that's the new Spider-Man figures. The set is not released yet. Not sure who that guy is. That's Dr. Octopus. That's Spider-Man, of course. Any other figures? And this is the comic book for this set. Somewhere. Don't know what's going on because I haven't seen the movie. He looks pissed. Pulling off donuts in the middle of the road. Hawkeye looks stoned. Yep, they're tripping. Definitely tripping. And then Iron Man is, you know, all cool-like. And he's dancing around with his crystal like a ballerina. Iron Man swooshes off. Then Iron Man gets pwned. The truck gets pwned. And they lose. And he's like, what happened? Yeah. So, I guess that's it. I don't know anything that's going on in this movie. And I actually don't know much about Avengers. But, yeah, let's get on to the figures. Here, first off, is Iron Man. Iron Man looks very cool. His helmet is a bit big, you know, that was a criticism. However, I think overall it looks good, except, you know, that's kind of a gap there. He's supposed to be in a suit of armor. Detail is very nice. These, you know, his little jets. You take them off, they're just studs. And helmet. Helmet. So let's open this baby up. And there's Tony Stark. On focus. There it's focused. I actually thought this was going to be Jack Sparrow's head, but it isn't. It is actually a new head. And that's Tony Stark. His armor doesn't come off, it's just his helmet. Next to get Loki. And Loki is kind of a disappointment in that because he has the same face as Lex Luthor. However, that tiny caveat aside, his robe is very nice. Could be used in fantasy. His staff, another, you know, I mean, this is reusing the Pharaoh's staff from the collectible minifigures, and then, of course, a golden sigh in there. like that. He has this crystal thing. I guess it has something to do with the movie. At the moment, it's not printed, so it's just a piece of plastic. And here's Loki again. He has a very cool helmet. It looks kind of like an alien helmet from the Elder Scrolls IV Oblivion. And it's all rubbery-like. It's a pretty cool helmet. I like that a lot. His face, of course, is the same as Lex Luthor's. And no back printing. But overall, you know, it's pretty nice. I was expecting a bit more for the antagonist. I mean, the main guy for this series. But he's like in almost all the sets, so can't expect much. Finally, the best figure of this set is Hawkeye. And I don't know much about Hawkeye at all, because I mostly know, you know, DC Comics. But Hawkeye looks very cool, nonetheless. I mean, his back printing's ace. Front printing and leg printing is top-notch there. Face is very cool. He's a compound bow, which is a brand new design. And even has a black hand there, and a white hand there. Well, it's a glove, actually, but, you know. He has a slick back hair in red. Or, you know, lightish red. And he also has a double-sided face. Taking off his goggles, and he's all kind of ticked off because someone took off his goggles. So, yeah, he's very cool and the best figure of this set. Finally, we have the truck, the SHIELD truck. I don't even know what SHIELD stands for, so it stands for something. I know it's an alliance, government, top secret, fight alien or something. But yeah, the truck is just kind of here. I mean, it plays a role in the movie. It's probably, you know, shown for 10 minutes and it gets blown up, that kind of role. And Lego, of course, they like trucks and cars, and kids like cars and trucks. They had to make it. So yeah, it has several stickers, and the stickers look very nice. And I actually got them on almost perfectly this time. Quite pleased. It has a fire extinguisher that doesn't actually work, so don't start fires and then use that, because that would be stupid. It has this sticker, you know, the hood, this little thing. And it has quickfire missiles, which I guess small hands, so you get in there. I can't do it. You have to have little, tiny hands. Back here is another play feature. It's kind of supposed to knock Loki off when he jumps on there. But if he, I don't know. In the comic, he was zapping it with green lasers. So I don't know why he has to jump on the back and do some ninja skills. And you can just zap and blow it up. And inside, there's a blue chair and some detail and sits one figure. Overall, it's a very nice truck. I mean, it's cool design. But, you know, kind of a parts package. It's nothing. Nothing to keep there, nothing to display. So hope you enjoyed this. A little longer than I thought, but you know, it's a new theme and have to kind of explain stuff as much as I can, even though I don't know anything about Avengers. But that's another story. Next, tomorrow, will be this review on this thing. This, which is also another throwaway vehicle just for the figures. So, junky looking set, but great figures. But I also have a couple others on pre-order, so they'll be hopefully coming arriving this week. And see you later. Until next time, hope you enjoyed this review, and bye.